No matter what happens, we can rest easy knowing that tomorrow is a new day. But that might not be something we'll be able to say in billions of years. The Earth's spin is slowing down. Eventually, days will get longer. And when they do, the lack of a daily dawn could be the least of our problems. The Earth spins because of the Mars-sized body that smashed into it when it was young. The collision set our planet spinning so fast the day was about 6 hours long, and it simultaneously knocked out a chunk of material that coalesced to become the Moon. Then the Earth and Moon settled into a gravitational relationship, one of the effects of which was that the Moon causes tides on the Earth. But with every tide cycle, the sloshing of Earth's water exerts just a little bit of friction on the surface, and it slows the planet's rotation ever so slightly. And every time the Earth's rotation slows, the Moon moves a bit further away. Over time, our day went from 6 to 24 hours, and the Moon retreated to its current distance of about 250,000 miles. And all the while, life on Earth adapted to a planet with a 24-hour day, tides, seasons, and an atmosphere whose wind patterns move east to west. Tidal friction could eventually slow the Earth significantly, but the laws of physics wouldn't allow it to stop completely. But still, what would happen during the slowdown? A non-rotating Earth would have a day that's half a year of sunlight and half a year of nighttime, similar to tidally locked planets like Mercury. This would make the days hotter and the nights colder, especially at the poles owing to the tilt of the Earth's axis. This would change global wind patterns to a north-south orientation, moving from the cool equator to the hot poles. The mid-latitudes would be the few non-extreme places with the right atmospheric density that could support life. That is, if there was even land to live on. The Earth isn't a perfect sphere. It's bulbous at the equator because of its rotation. As the rotation slows, the oceans would migrate towards the poles, leaving a mega-continent around the equator. And that new continent would have some interesting geology. The layers of the Earth would all slow at different rates, the resulting friction causing massive earthquakes and volcanic activity before everything stopped. And without that spinning core, we'd lose the lovely protective magnetic field, making the planet and its weird new atmosphere extremely vulnerable to solar radiation. If this global change didn't kill off all life on Earth, the lack of the 24-hour day might. Recent studies have shown that the circadian clock that controls all living things is actually at the cellular level. Even species that don't rely on sunlight, like mussels, show more gene expression based on circadian cycles than the rising and falling tides that drives their muscular activity. And of course, plants and things like plankton, the bottom of the food chain that needs sunlight for photosynthesis, probably wouldn't stand a chance in the 6-month-long nights. The good news is that our planet's slowdown is super gradual. In the last 100 years, the Earth's rotation slowed by about 1.4 milliseconds, meaning our day got 1.4 milliseconds longer. In 2012, we added a second to the clock to compensate. It'll be 180 million years before our day gets an hour longer. We'll theoretically be able to adapt to the time shift over that long a period, but we'll most likely be wiped out by some other great extinction by then. Really, we'll be long dead before we have to deal with the Earth's slowing rotation. But still, it's fun to think about, eh? Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more science videos. And if you want to learn a little bit more about how circadian cycles work, I talked more about how they affect sleep in this video right here. And fun fact, back in the year 1820, a day on Earth was exactly 24 hours. Today, it's 24 hours and 2 milliseconds. We have to make that up every century with a leap second.